Welcome to today's tutorial. We'll deploy nginx Helm charts with Terraform to AWS EKS. Also, we'll dive into Helm provider and Helm release resources in our hands-on demo. Hi everyone, welcome back to my channel. My name is Lian Duan, and I have developed for over 20 years, specializing in DevOps and cloud security. You can find the related content and code in my GitLab repository and my blog. Today we'll cover Helm provider concept and configuration, understanding Helm release resources, and hands-on demo. Let's start with Helm provider concept. The Helm provider connects Terraform with the Helm command line interface to deploy software packages in Kubernetes cluster. It lets bridge between Helm and Terraform, requiring configuration and credentials setup. Helm provider has three configuration options. Using a kubectl file, setup credentials, and execution plugins. Today we'll focus on the kubeconfig file and plugins. If you're interested in how to use credentials, please leave a comment below. I'll create a video, do it together. Move to using kubeconfig file. The kubeconfig file has the authentication details for accessing the Kubernetes cluster. As my screenshot, it uses a .kube folder that under the user home folder. The file name is config. The config file has authentication detail to access the Kubernetes cluster. We can use AWS EKS update kubeconfig command to update the config information. In our hands-on demo Terraform main.tl file, resource update kubeconfig, while running the AWS EKS update kubeconfig command after the EKS cluster created. Next, move to the execution plugins. The plugin has three config items. Let's go through it one by one. Helm declares the Helm provider. Host specifies the endpoint of the AWS EKS cluster for Kubernetes API access. Cluster CA certificate. It sets the CA certificate for authenticating the Kubernetes API server. ESEC block used to config AWS command and the related parameters. After understanding the Helm provider, let's dive into the Helm release resource. Helm release resource is used to deploy Helm charts to EKS. The resource screenshot is from our hands-on demo main.tl file. Let's go through it. The name is specified the name of Helm release. This name will be used to identify the deployment application within the Kubernetes cluster. You can see the value is the same as Helm install command name parameter. Repository indicates the URL of the Helm chart repository from which chart will be reached. In this case, we are using my public repository hosted on GitHub. The URL is used by Helm rip add command. Chart specifies the name of the Helm chart to deploy. In our demo, we're deploying the demo-nginx chart. The chart is based on the official nginx Docker image. I only add the index page on it. The chart and the version value are same as Helm install command. Depend on is the Terraform function. That ensures that Helm release deploy only after the EKS node group it provisioned. Next, move to hands-on demo. There are some prerequisites for our hands-on demo. Let me open my blog. There are more details. Move a little bit down. First, you need an AWS free tier account. Second, if you do not have a Terraform on your box yet, there's official doc for Helm installation. Also, you can check my video to install Terraform on Linux and Windows. We are going to need Helm. I provide official doc link in there. Also, there's my video has a step-by-step guideline how to install Helm on Windows 11. Kubectl command line 2 is required in my demo. There are 3 official document links for different operating systems. Finally, you also need config AWS command line interface on your box. If you have got any questions, just leave them below. I'll be happy to help you out. Back to my slides. Let's quickly go over our hands-on demo. In Terraform main.tl file, it create an EKS cluster with the 1EC2 T3 middle work node. After the cluster created, Helm release resource will deploy the nginx chart, and then we'll verify the deployment together. Very important things to save your cost. Clean up the AWS resources after your exercise. Open my terminal. Make sure you download the main.tl file from my blog or repository, and then run following command in the main.tl file folder. First, run Terraform init to download all the required Terraform module file. Initialize successfully. Clean up the screen. Run next command, Terraform apply, to create the EKS cluster and deploy the Helm chart. Enter yes to move forward. The creation process will take 20 minutes. The output log has useful information. We see the VPC and the 2 public subnets are creating. I highlight the information cluster is created, node group creating start. Also, you see the .kubeconfig file get updated. During the waiting time, let me open the main.tl file. You see there are 2 Helm providers. I test both. In current code, we use the EICC plugins. If you want to try the config file options, just come out EICC plugins provider and uncomment the second Helm provider. Let's check the creating progress. Add-ons still creating. I highlighted the useful information. In the Terraform, we run the kubectl gate service. Name is demo-nginx. In this command output, we got the public IP. Let me copy the IP address and open in the browser to verify the deployment status. The protocol is HTTP. If you see the welcome page, that means Helm deployed the nginx chart successfully. Add-ons still in creating. When this creating completed, do not forget run Terraform destroy to clean up all the resources. This is all for today's topic. As you know, by combining Helm charts with Terraform, we are simplifying the application deployment on AWS EKS, ensuring the consistency and scalability in deployment workflow. Thank you for watching and see you in the next time.